looks like it's running at a like 720p or 1080p, rather large and jaggy to start with.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say 720 is the default resolution. Does not look good. Because even 1080p still looks nice on this monitor, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
And the fraps, the size of the fraps numbers gives it away.
720. And one thing that's interesting is it's a number of games, like Hawks did it, is it's defaulting to 30 hertz.
Uh-huh.
Even at the lower res, where the panel will handle more.
Alright.
I noticed as we were going through the res options there, that it was sitting on the 30 hertz. And so, if you do end up with one of these panels, and you do play the lower res, like 1080p, you need to make sure that if the game has it, you're picking a the proper refresh rate.
Although I noticed before that even when I was playing on 1080p in Dirt Showdown, I would change that up to like 60 or higher, and every time I'd go back into the menu, it was back at 30.
So here we've got everything on. Sitting here at 144 some odd frames a second.
The rain almost looks so sharp, it looks like needles coming down or something.
Yeah. I guess I don't have one here. So this has got a fairly lengthy intro movie, unfortunately, with no way to skip it that I've ever found. So any testing that I've done on a new box has been a pain. And it's, so there's no Steam Cloud Sync. So you can pull a save game that puts you past this. The frame rate up here is at 144. It was sitting at 30 or so to start with, but now we're locked in right around 30. And I'm seeing lots of tearing in here.
Yeah.
We're up to 120, 150 frames a second.
It looks great. I mean,
it looks very shiny and plasticky.
It does.
As you would expect.
It does have more of a movie kind of feel to it. Like, it does... I don't know. It is different to 1080p. Like, it... It's just the unfortunate thing is the tearing. I mean, we're at 150 frames a second, or we're still quite high before, and... I mean, we're not seeing so much now, but when it was panning around outside,
right,
it's very noticeable.
And one thing in the gameplay here is closer to Torchlight.
Right.
In that the world is fixed and you're running around in it, there's not that panning and turning. And it's funny that we would say that, in a sense, that this looks so sharp and crisp and nice, because LEGO figures, by default, have very little detailing.
Yeah. You know, I think it's coming back to what was said last night about the reflections in Showdown were super crisp. The sort of, I think is what is coming across to me is just the reflections of the plastic on the Lego man.
Right.
You can see the detail in the reflection, you know.
You can see here that this is a very low-res movie that they had pre-rendered in there.
Right.
And so, if we draw the conclusion or the comparison that it is the reflections and sort of the environmental, whether it's the SSAO or whatnot, that is, you know, those types of things, those, the eye candy pieces, the reflections, the SSAO, that you're really able to see and that stand out more at 4K, then it becomes somewhat ironic that you need to ensure that you have enough hardware to turn those things on.
Right. I think the tearing might start to annoy me after a while. I mean, we've got more than enough GPU grunt to run this game. I mean, everything's running at 120 frames a second. I don't know what's going to solve the tearing issue. We're running at 120 to 150 frames a second and we're still seeing tearing on a game like this, you know. I'm not sure what's going to solve the tearing, but it's certainly a noticeable issue.
So I would say we're back at 150 frames a second. There's some textures here in these cloaks I've never noticed before. Again, I played this level here in particular a number of times. I have to figure out what the actual controls are, because I always play with
Okay, so we've got VSync off, and we're running at about 150-ish frames a second. Do you feel that the 30 hertz panel is impairing you at all?
Not at all. I mean, this feels fluid, it feels fast, it feels just as natural or normal as it did testing in 1080p. And again, like Torchlight, I've played this level in the two levels in probably several dozen times. I don't think the 30 hertz on the panel is really a detriment at all. I would suppose, you know, some of the other panels that are coming out that are only about $100 more that had 60 hertz refresh rate, you know, you might as well go for them anyway. But I would say it's not a detriment.
So really, this would be perfect if there was no tearing.
I would say in a lot of the games that we've played, it's an issue of tearing, and we can't figure out why it comes from. You know, in some sense, we thought it was not enough horsepower. Now it seems like there's almost too much. It's like there's not a... We can't find that happy medium or what the cause is. Now, if I come in here and put on VSync, it sinks us all the way back down to 30 hertz. And again, it would be nice if a game would do a multiple of your display. Maybe that defeats the whole purpose.
I can already see the lag when you were going through the menu items.
Yeah, and see this now, it feels sluggish.
Yeah, you feel disconnected.
Absolutely. And so any disconnect that's there, any other reviews that you... Yeah, I mean, if you look at just this little bit right here, it's like I'm clicking it and then it's going there. It's clicking it and then it's going there.
Yeah. I mean, I could even see it when you're just navigating through the menus.
Right.
It's like the delay between pressing the button and having a response.
Now here, I mean, it's much, much more responsive. So, the limiter seems not to be the 30 hertz, it seems to be the tearing.
Right. And in really graphically intensive games, the limit might be your GPU, depending on how much
right
GPU horsepower you've got. So.